Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome back to Let's Play Fallout New Vegas, where we're in Good Springs, where we've just finished burying Benny in the grave that was originally meant for us, because I'm rather a fan of poetic justice, don't you know? Anyway, as you can see, I've got a new suit. Compliments of Mr. House, that creepy female robot dropped it off the previous morning, along with the hat. Rather nice. For those curious, it's the Ranger Grey hat, because people always ask, what hat are you wearing? It's the Ranger Grey hat, which I actually retextured myself, because I didn't like the way the original one looked. And it fit better with the outfit this way, so, you know. I can, if people are desperate to get their hands on it, I can upload that retexture to the Nexus if strictly speaking necessary. But anyway, just thought I'd let you know the outfit itself, actually, because people will ask this undoubtedly as well, is not a single outfit. It's actually a combination of a bunch of stuff. It's from two mods called TaylorMade and Spice of Life. Now, Spice of Life provides a whole bunch of outfits, and normally I wouldn't have really installed it because it requires you to install a body mod to get it to work. However, there is one outfit in it, this suit, which I saw a screenshot of and was instantly like, holy shit, I want this. And while it apparently does need a body mod to work, this particular outfit, this suit here, seems to work just fine with the vanilla body without too many issues. There is one small issue, being that if I get my rifle out and then zoom in without the rifle equipped, this happens. You can fix that by, oddly enough, equipping the power fist, unequipping it, and then it goes back to normal. But anyway, yeah, it's a strange mesh bug, which I'm 99.9% certain is either just a general problem with the outfit, or it's a problem with the fact that I'm not using the body mod that the mod author obviously said was required, so it is my own stupid fault. But what can I say? I'm lazy, I don't like installing body mods. There's the suit. The gloves are a separate item. They're also from Spice of Life. They're called the Roughhide gloves, left and right. And the ammo belt here, with our little 308 rounds on it for the rifle, that's actually from TaylorMade. That's a little accessory you can pop on there, because normally it doesn't look like that, the suit, but I added this to it because I thought it looked cool. There you go. Because I knew people would ask about that. I've also obviously got my sunglasses. But, which I can't make my mind up about, to be honest with you. They look kind of cool, but at the same time, I think it looks classier without them on. For some reason, it looks a bit more old-fashioned. And Sir David Crumpington's rather a fan of things that are old-fashioned, don't you know? So, yeah. There you go. I've also got a large duffel bag to replace my old leather backpack. The reason for this is, one, it looks a bit better, because it's one of the actual duffel bags you find lying around in the game. Two, it's one of the few modded backpacks I've ever seen that actually has a strap. And three, it actually has better carrying capacity than the leather backpack. The downside to it is we have 10 less AP while wearing it. However, while we were wearing the leather one, we actually had -2 agility, which probably works out slightly worse than -10 AP, to be honest with you. So, you know, we don't want to be wearing this all the time, though, obviously, because of that. And right now, I don't actually need to, so, because I've only got 103 weight. So that's not a problem, but it is there if we need it. It's carrying, the additional carrying capacity from the large duffel bag is, in fact, 65 extra pounds of weight. So, that's pretty sweet. Whereas I think the leather backpack was 50 pounds. And an extra 15 pounds of carrying capacity is nothing to sniff at, really. So, it could be the difference between carrying an extra gun or not. So, there you go. Weapons-wise, I've changed the loadout a bit and sort of lessened it a little, actually. First weapon is Maria, Benny's pistol. Which is not actually that good. It looks awesome. I absolutely love the way it looks. But I'm using it just because it's a 9mm crappy weapon I can use to shoot geckos with. And I don't know, I'm sort of morbidly fascinated by the idea of wielding the gun that almost killed us. Also, I've got the Webley. Incidentally, which is the gun that killed Benny. I've got the good old trusty Enfield with scope attached at this present moment. I've got the Q35 Matter Modulator for anything that's tougher than a regular human. And I've got the Power Fist for anything that's tougher than a regular non-human, I guess. And or close quarters. Basically, whenever I run into sentry bots, I want to run up to them and punch them in the face with this. So, there you go. So, moving on. In fact, I'll keep this equipped for now. It is a pretty gun, isn't it? I mean, you can't deny it. It is lovely. Anyway. Yes, as I said, we just buried Benny. Not me knocking my desk in the background. We just buried Benny up on the hill. We took no real pride in it, other than the sort of sweet irony of burying him where he once buried me. Because I don't think we really held any genuine malice for Benny in the end. Some people might have in that situation been, you know, desperate for revenge, and I can't help but notice that annoying glitch with the animation glitch with the hands. It's a problem in the vanilla game. It bugs me to no end. It really does. I don't know. I'm pretty sure that's a vanilla bug. I don't know if anyone else has ever fixed that, but yeah, it annoys the pants off me anyway. No, we don't have to look at the hands now. I don't think we ever had any real malice for him in the end. A lesser person might have been hell-bent on revenge, but we really weren't in the end. What was done. And ultimately, he had to die because he wouldn't give us the platinum chip. If he had, we might have let him live, honestly. I think by the time we finally reached Vegas and we actually met Benny face to face, we just sort of didn't care anymore. But nevertheless, he is dead now. Naturally, it goes without saying that if you play the game for yourself, you need not kill Benny in the casino like I did. There are actually a whole heap of different ways to deal with Benny in this game. I chose one of the admittedly most clumsy and ridiculous ways of dealing with him, but there it is. Anyway, yeah, so. Oh, right, yeah, all the decorations and furniture and stuff arrived for the house, so I might as well show you guys that while we're here. Ta-da! It's a bit more homely now, got a few rugs and stuff. And a dining table. And that sort of thing. Ooh, the sink. Can I? You fill all the bottles you carry. Yeah, excellent, I did want to do that. For some reason, you can't do that with this sink, probably because it's a modded one or something, doesn't apply with the bottle that water mod. I don't know. We've got a guitar! We do. We've got a guitar and we've got a Wasteland Survival Guide. Let's quickly read that before I forget. Where would I find that? I've already read a Wasteland Survival Guide, so has that just been added to my MISC thing as a result of that? It might have done. No, I don't see it anyway. It should be prefaced a book. Odd. It seems to have just disappeared. Strange. Anyway, never mind. Yeah. And some Nuka-Cola. And a guitar. Which reminds me. We still need to find a job for that Lonesome Drifter fella. With his guitar. Come to think of it. Oh, look at that. Little gramophone thing. Lincoln's voice. So, yeah. Moving on. Yeah, I like that mod a lot. That's my favourite mod. We're now heading out. Richard, you're going to drive back to Vegas. I've got everybody in the van at the moment. They're all sort of stuck in there, cramped, and waiting for me to come and fetch them. And we're going to drive back up to Vegas, where I'm going to dismiss a few people and send them to go wait at the Lucky 38 for us, because we really don't need more than two people following us around at once. Three at a push, I think. So, yeah. And we're gonna go off and start looking for this Glanton fellow. The chap, if I need to remind you, which you may have forgotten about, to be honest with you, the chap which Russell agreed to come with us in order to hunt in the first place. So we're ultimately a pair of bounty hunters looking for a chap called Glanton, who's worth 10,000 caps. So hopefully he won't try to double cross me like in a few dollars more, but well, we can see. We'll wait and see. And beyond that, we also have the bounty on Tom Quigley for Randall and Associates, which we still haven't got around to doing. Randall's probably thinking by this point we got ourselves killed, and has moved on and gone to look for someone else at this point, I imagine. But yeah, we'll get around to that. We'll need to go shoot Tom Quigley, bring his finger back to Randall, and then we'll see what else he's got for us. Because, as I said, we're out of money. We lost it all on gambling, unfortunately, on that bender we had in Vegas after we dealt with Benny. We're not actually as bad off as you might think, though, for one simple reason. And that simple reason... Where the hell's the miscellaneous crap stored? Metal box, reloading parts, sorted ammo. No, I won't be in sorted ammo with it. Trying to think. Misc items. Currency? Would that go in the safe, maybe? Unless I've got it all on me. Because we have an abundant supply of scrap metal. Which reminds me, I need to grab out of here. And NCR dollars. I mean, not NCR dollars. Pre-war dollars, which I'm now going to proceed to forge into actual money, which we can then exchange for bottle caps. However, that's a bit of a roundabout way of going about things. So, you know, it probably won't amount to as much money as I'm thinking it will, but we'll see. Either way, we're going to go and do these bounties. We're going to actually do our job as a bounty hunter for once and go hunt some bloody criminals. Yes, we are. Mr. House's little errand with us to go meet Caesar at Fortification Hill can wait for now. We don't really give a damn about that for the moment. We're still thinking things over, and frankly, we've got the platinum chip now, so, you know. Mr. House can't do shit. Basically, we're untouchable. Dean and Paul, though, I would like to speak to you guys first.
Can I help you, friend?
The furniture and decorations look bloody marvelous.
Yeah, I took a peek in there myself and thought the same thing. I'm glad you like them. Hey, that dealer's finally been able to find everything we talked about, and he sent me all the purchase orders, so we're ready to go. Just let me know what you want to buy, and we'll get it delivered.
Okay, will do.
Hey, just one more thing. How would you like to have a little raised garden out back? You know, to grow stuff you can cook up on your new oven? What good is the oven without the ingredients you need for crafting, right? Anyway, think about it a little while, and we could talk more about it later if you want to.
Yeah, I suppose I better go, because...
Don't be a stranger, neighbor.
I can't afford any of that now. Crap. All the more reason to go bounty hunting. Okay. Oh dear, oh dear, oh dear. Is it just me, or am I running a bit slowly? I feel like I'm running slower than normal. Whatever. Doesn't matter. I wonder if I should trim the moustache a bit. Honestly. It kind of does make... It has this kind of Lee Van Cleef look about it. Which I do like. But on the other hand, I don't know. Whatever, I'll think about it. Right. Let me just find a workbench. I know there's one in the van, but there's also five bloody other people in the van right now, so it'd be a bit of a mess to try and negotiate around. Forge Legion coins. 44 of them. NCR money. 100. 44 Legion Aureus is added, and 100 NCR bills. So that's... Jesus Christ, that's like 10,000? Yeah, that's 10,000 NCR dollars we're now in the possession of, which probably won't equate to as much as you think in bottle caps, even though it sounds like a lot. I don't think the NCR dollar is worth a terrific amount these days. Where would I have gone? Misc. Sure. Yeah, there it is. Legion Aureus is on the other hand. That's worth 4,400 and I've still got more pre-war money. Holy crap! I can only do 100 at a time. That's the problem. Okay, there we go. Right. Currency. I got Legion Denarius as well. Okay, so yeah, we got just under 10,000 caps worth of NCR dollars. That's impressive. Remains to be seen whether we'll actually get that for it, but whatever. I wonder if Bert's got any more scrap metal. I think that was all of it, but I could be wrong.
Hey.
Oh dear God. At least none of you have sort of gone all, Call of Cthulhu, black, dark voids of hell on me, which is nice. Yeah, sorry guys, I know it's a bit cramped in here, just...
Motherfucker.
Yeah, you have 5 more bits of scrap metal, excellent. You also have that other suit of power armor, which I might get repaired at some point, although it's probably going to cost me a fortune. And you have my radiation suit. Mustn't forget about that. Okay.
Fuck.
There we go. More currency. Oh, alright then, chaps. Let's see if we can offload this stuff. To Chet, why not? We don't really like Chet anyway, so... Let's give him a bunch of forged money. Why not? What the... I had this bug earlier. This little glitch here with the lightning on the roads. What the fuck's that about? I have to... Yeah, it's very strange. Don't know. Anyway. Weird. If anyone knows what that's about, let me know. I haven't already fixed it by this point. Good Springs General Store. Chet. Hello. Probably takes Legion money. Legion money doesn't need the jammy bastard. Right. Currency. Just re-offload first these, I guess. 4,900 caps. Hey! Alright, that was an easy 5,000 caps. That will sadly only buy 2 house upgrades, though, so it's pretty small potatoes still, admittedly. But at least we're not completely broke anymore. Out of the way, box. Okay, ladies and gents, we're moving out. We're going to... Oh, shit, what would be the best place to go? Canyon Wreckage, no, Freeside. Probably Freeside. Any minute now. Strange truck driving itself. Strange pre-war technology.
Hey.
Okay, everybody. Okay. So, I think... We're going to bring Russell, obviously.
Lead on.
Now, the question is... I think, Boone, you can... Grumpy sod, you can sort of just... you can pop off back to the Lucky 38. You can, you can go... Finish going cold turkey on that ultra jet you were taking.
That guy Benny was a piece of work.
He sure was. And you can... we'll have a heart-to-heart chat about stuff later where you can sit there and go, yup, nope, at me for a bit. Part ways for now.
If that's what you think.
Lucky 38, yeah.
I'll make my way there.
Okay, now. That's sorted. Now the question is... Bert or Veronica? And I really can't decide. You're both just too awesome. He smashes things, you punch things. He has a minigun. You have a laser gun. And you have power armor. On the other hand, do I trust Bert by himself in the Lucky 38?
Motherfucker.
Nah, you're probably right. Okay, sorry, Veronica. I promise I'll do something with you later. I know that sounds wrong, but... Bert, just... Oh, love it. Never mind.
You know, I've been thinking. The real problem with the Brotherhood is that we isolate ourselves. Our training is top-notch.
Okay.
Our technology gives us an advantage. But when it all comes down to it, we're losing because we shun the outside world. We always make enemies, never allies. We refuse to recruit outsiders or see the value in their simpler technologies.
Well, why don't you do something about it then?
I don't know. I'm still thinking about what kind of role we could take on that would give us the best chance of survival. But I think things are starting to come together. I know the odds aren't good, but I gotta try. I can't lose them.
Good. Well, you know what? You go and have a think about
Why
that.
Why does everyone always say that?
And, you know, and you have and chill out in the Lucky 38 and mull things over, and please try not to piss off Mr. House, and I will see you later, okay?
Nice! Can I order room service?
Absolutely. I encourage it. Okay. Try not to mess up the cocktail lounge. Oh, never mind.
Motherfucker.
Okay, so Bert Russell. Bertrand Russell. But I can't believe I didn't think of that before. No, never mind. yeah, let's go, guys. Oh dear, Bertrand Russell. Oh, God, feel free to virtually slap me in the face with such a terrible pun. Oh, God, what is happening? Oh, the Securitrons are shooting someone. Okay, fine. Where's Bird gone? Oh, is he? I didn't tell him to follow me, did I? Herb de derp de derp. Bert.
Motherfucker.
Do show a little initiative from time to time. Okay, right. Now then. Right, we're actually in Freeside right now, which is not actually specifically where I wanted to be. I actually wanted to park outside Freeside, to be honest, but never mind. The van is... a little safer here, maybe? I don't know. Whatever.
Man, oof. I thought those tin cans of Mr. House's were tough before. Have you seen the shit they can do now?
Yeah, funnily enough, I have. They've been upgraded. Oh! You continue gunning down random people, Mr. King's member. Good grief. Okay, now we have to go through here to get to the other bit of Freeside and... and out the exit, finally. One of the exits. I've considered getting one of those mods that opens up Freeside in the Strip, but I don't think my computer can handle it, to be honest with you. I don't know, it's weird. Like, I get better frame rates in Skyrim than I do in Fallout New Vegas, for some odd reason. That's why I have an ENB installed for Skyrim now, and I don't have one installed for... New Vegas. As far as I'm aware, though, the originally the Strip was designed to be much, much bigger. Holy crap. Jesus Christ, okay. Okay, guys, let's go. Right, let's have a look at the map. Yeah, it was originally designed to be bigger, I think, but basically, just as with many things, a limited time constraints, very limited budget. Believe it or not, Obsidian had 18 months to make all this. That's all. Fallout 3 was given 4 years of development time, whereas New Vegas was given 18 months. which is frankly a little criminal, but still, they got a pretty good game out of it. Arguably a better one than Fallout 3, in my honest opinion, but let's not open that can of worms right now. Yeah, it was meant to be bigger, the strip, but console limitations, essentially, meant that they had to cut it down and make it smaller, which is a shame. Homeroom, no. No, 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 no. No. Yes. Investigate the abandoned hideouts. Hunter hunted, that's the one, isn't it, I think. And then there's another one. We can rebuild him as well, that's in the area too. Yeah. Hang on a minute, where is... Okay, right, I see. Okay, so we can go up there and then down here. And then down here somewhere is where Tom Quigley is. So, right, that's the plan. Where is it? Where is it? Where is it? Where is it? Hunter hunted. Investigate the abandoned hideout. I forget exactly, to be honest with you, why we are investigating this place. I really do. Maybe we should ask Russell.
What's up?
I'd like to ask you something.
Like what?
Can you tell me anything else about Glanton? Yeah, why not?
There's a lot of scuttlebutt about his origins. Stories of his family being killed by tribals, him swearing vengeance. Probably bullshit. Not surprisingly, he's supposed to be a devil with a knife. Very quick. Runs a tight crew also. Real authoritarian. Once he sets his sights on a tribe, they're gonna get theirs one way or another. He's never failed to fulfill a contract.
I see. Yes, this is the gentleman who has been going around sort of butchering entire tribes of tribals when asked to by settlers and miners and stuff, which obviously makes him kind of an asshole. Not that I have anything against, you know, wiping out hordes of savage tribals or anything like that, old chap, but the thing is, you know, it's one thing to, you know, fight tribals when they attack you, and it's quite another to completely just wipe them out. So, what we should be doing is what Mr. House has been doing, which is just sort of civilizing tribals and integrating them into a civilized modern society and all that sort of thing, like the chairman and whatnot. They were tribals at one point, you see. So, rather than just killing all of them. What else? What's your problem with Boone? I didn't realize he had a problem with Boone, but fine.
Problem? I just don't like the fucker. Maybe it's his first recon, sense of entitlement, or his bullshit thousand-yard stare. Real tough guy, killing unarmed women and children. Fuck him and his stupid beret. Only cocksuckers wear those things anyway.
Yep, wouldn't know anything about that. Boone is a valuable part of this team, and your remarks are undermining our cohesion. Stop it.
Fine, it's your crew. I'll knock it off. Just don't expect me to be fucking friends with the guy.
I don't think anyone is fucking friends with Boone, frankly, Russell, so you've got nothing to worry about there. Anything else? Let's not ask about his face. That would be... That seems awfully rude, frankly. Were you in the military? You seem to know how to handle yourself.
Yeah, the Desert Rangers. Ever heard of them?
No, outside of Wasteland 2, no. I've seen that monument at the Mojave Outpost, and that's about it, I'm afraid.
Figures. That Tower of Scrap is our tombstone. Desert Rangers were here long before the NCR showed up. We kept the Mojave safe, or at least tried. NCR is fucking soft. All lazy conscripts waiting to finish their tours. Well-supplied, armed to the teeth. We didn't have those luxuries. There were never that many of us, and supplies were uneven. We had training and discipline, though. That's why we won all our battles. Plenty of former Desert Rangers are serving in the NCR now, and they're good people. That wasn't for me, though. I won't live a lie.
Well, what happened then? Why did they join the NCR?
Legion happened. It was a trickle at first, just the scouts. Then they started showing up in force. We killed them, and more would take their place. Legionaries practiced total war, killing or enslaving entire towns that helped us. A lot of people started having a change of heart. With dwindling supplies and manpower, some of the Rangers began to see our struggle as futile. We fought on, regardless. Maybe the Legion would have lost interest if we'd continued giving them bloody noses. I wish we'd had a nuke. We won almost every battle, but we lost the war. Even if the NCR stops Lanius, the Mojave's identity will be gone.
I see. Alright then, well, let's get going.
Lead on.
I believe this place we're looking for has something to do with... Obviously it has something to do with Glanton. I think we're looking for someone who knows something about Glanton, who may or may not be at this hideout. Yeah, it's abandoned hideout. This is probably where this person was. I really can't remember. I'm sorry, Russell. My memory's like a sieve these days, and the, you know, the gaping hole in my brain that we got left behind by this... Oops. This exact gun really doesn't help with things. So... Yeah. Now then, I think I might actually switch to this. I really need to be really super fucking careful at the moment, because the side effect of wearing this rather snazzy suit, well, one of the side effects, I mean the main side effect is that we look rather dashing. The other side effect of it though is that my DT is really crap now. DT of 8 is not really that brilliant at all. As a matter of fact, it's really quite crappy. I'm gonna have to take some ranks in toughness and stuff via perks and things, I think, to balance it out a bit. Hello. What do we have here? Why am I getting depth of field issues? Let me just do the old quick save, quick load thing. Oh, never mind! Apparently the game didn't take too kindly to me doing that. Okay, that was a bit odd. Still, it happens from time to time.
I can do that. Good call.
Yeah, don't use the knife. Oh, you know what, you'll be fine. I think the minigun's a bit overkill most of the time anyway. No. Follow me and be passive for now. I don't want you guys running off to kill things until I... Well, until someone starts shooting at you, really, to be honest with you. These do not look friendly, let's be honest. I've said it before and I'll say it again. Anyone wearing metal armor like that is bad news, without any exceptions. This is curious, though. Reckon we can take him? I reckon we can. Point is, though, do we want to? Do we need to? Not really in our way. Or am I hungry? Oh yeah, I'm really hungry. Holy shit. Let's stop for a spot of lunch, shall we? On our way to, you know... Did that do anything? Wasteland omelette. There we go. Alright. Here goes. One down. Two down. Oh, that wasn't a person. Oh, yes, it was. It's just my bullet didn't... Oh, I think we have an invincible wall. That's what the problem is. Holy shit, is that power armor? It is. Well, it was. We do, in fact, have people wearing... I'm pretty sure it's Rangers wearing... Rangers? Raiders wearing... power armor. Oops. that a lot? I mean, I know fiends when I see them, but the power armor's a bit of an odd touch. Tech Raider Outpost North. Oh, well, there you go. All doubts has now been removed. Some of the grass looks a bit weird. Whatever. Alright then, what do we got? Cat eye, always nice. Although I don't use a terrific amount of it, do I? Now, to be said, Service Rifle Mark II. Bleh. We'll take a bit selling. Tech Psycho. Makarov Chrome Finish. Ooh, valuable. Scrap Electronic. Oh, can I not take your power armor? Oh, bollocks. Fair enough, I guess. Game balancing for you. Lever action shotgun Mark II. Ooh. Yeah, I do have an option, and this is obviously from A World of Pain. Ooh, 12.7mm pistol. Holy crap. Yeah, I do. This is from A World of Pain. He had a BB gun? Really? That's an interesting combo. Power armor and a BB gun. Right. Did have a laser rifle as well, I suppose, but still, Jesus Christ. And I can pick up this power armor, okay. But you can hold on to the power armor for now. What's the stats on it like? DT20. That's not brilliant, is it, really? For power armor. Also, agility minus 2 when you're wearing it. That's, well, it's the T45D, which is comparatively crappy compared to some of the other power armors out there. Seriously though, DT20 is really shit. That's like 2 points less than the duster I used to wear. You can have that and the additional weapons. I'm just gonna hold on to that for a second though. This 12.7mm pistol. I'm not gonna sell that either. I'm keeping that. I wanna repair it because that's a heck of a pistol. You can have that. And that, and that, and that. Yep, I'm gonna pick up all of this shit, because we're gonna need to sell it. However, I am curious. This fires 12.... Because I've been told that 12.7mm rounds and 50 caliber rounds are different things, obviously. I figured they probably were. I figured they were just pretty much exactly the same, but they are... just with different names, obviously, or different manufacturers, but that's not strictly speaking the case. Apparently the 12.7mm rounds in this game supposedly represent 12 points, basically 50 caliber pistol rounds. They have a different, you know, jacket and that kind of thing. Cartridge, whatever you want to call it. To the 50 cal ones, which the 50 cal ones in this game are obviously the really big-ass 50 cal machine gun type jobbies. Now, but I'm curious, because that Raider had both 50 cal rounds and 12.7mm ones, so I'm wondering if... No, you cannot, actually. Okay, I was wondering if I could switch ammo to fight the 50 cal rounds as well as the 12.7mm. But it doesn't seem to be the case. Which is fair enough, but yeah. Because I wondered if it was a bit like the... with like the Webley that can fire 357 and 38 special, so... But anyway, this is a really nice gun, by the way. Kablam. I guess it's the Fallout equivalent of the Desert Eagle. Yeah, really, really nice. Gonna repair this and get some more ammo for it. In the meantime, let us continue, gentlemen. Oh, hang on a minute. I'm not quite done looting. You see? Pick up all the drugs and hopefully remember to sell them at some point. This lot didn't stand a chance, did they? AI in this game is quite dreadful. especially when you're sniping at it from a distance. It just doesn't know what to do with itself. Ooh, was that a 44 Magnum revolver? Mark II, it might have been. With a revolver scope. DPS 68. Damage 34 in a admittedly quite bad state. That's interesting. And I can mod it with a scope as well. Ooh. Ooh. That is kind of nice, you know. Colonel Mortimer would be proud. Now all I need for it is a stock. That's kind of cool. I think I might keep that, actually. I don't think I've got a gun that fires 44 rounds already, so... Ooh, hello! Is this the urge to pick up cartons of cigarettes? I've been playing Fallout 3 recently. And in that game, with Fallout Wanderers Edition installed, cartons of cigarettes are like gold. In fact, they're more valuable than gold. But not so in this game. In fact, it's one of those weird things. Like, I started playing with Fallout Wanderers Edition again recently, and I swear to God the AI is actually better in that than it is in New Vegas. With Project Nevada, it just is. If I'd been shooting at those guys from over there in Fallout 3 with the Wanderers Edition mod, they pretty much all would have instantly converged on me and shot me to bits, but I seem to be able to get away with it in New Vegas for some reason. Probably one of my few complaints about this game. Then again, I wonder. There is an option in here somewhere. Where is it? Being rebalanced, stealth and move. Experimental detection AI. Let's put that on. Because I think that causes the AI to react to people getting shot next to them as they naturally would. I'll give it a go anyway. Not that I mind mowing them down like that from a distance with the old sniper rifle, but it gets a bit old quite fast actually. To the point where it feels like I'm exploiting the game really more than anything else. Now, what am I doing that for? Because I don't have a compass. I need to rely on the old map. This way-ish. I think. Yes, more or less. What do we have here? Dead Brahmin. Multiple dead Brahmin. Flickering terrain. That, my friends, I believe is what we are looking for. Look at him with his rebar club. Oh, but your taste in weaponry never ceases to fascinate me. Yeah, this is the place, alright. I'm almost certain of it, yep. Okay. Expect in here, so I don't know which I'd be better off with, this or this. Probably this. I think it does more damage, so just has less magazine capacity. Sorry guys, am I causing you all to spaz out a bit every time I switch weapon? Okay, right, Bill's shack. Here we go.
This is the place. I searched it up and down, couldn't find shit. Maybe some fresh eyes will do the trick.
Alrighty. Ooh! Star bottle cap, excellent. I'll find that treasure one day, damn it. Creme. Maize. Oh, why not? AKA corn. I do believe maize is just another word for corn. Oh, hello.
Swift and silent.
Yep, yep, yep. Clanton's safe very... Oh, crap. Please tell me there's a key around here somewhere. Out of curiosity, by the way. No. Wrong menu. Oops. I forgot you have to keep it held down. Stats. Guns and sneak, and that's pretty much... Oh, and melee. You're pretty good in melee, too. Okay. I was wondering if he was any good at lockpicking and stuff like that, because... Like, for example, I don't really have to concentrate on science very much, because I've got Veronica, which is probably one more reason I probably should have brought Veronica instead of you. No offense, Bird, but... Brahmin steak, why not? Yeah, I mean, I've got Veronica for dealing with computers. Well, most computers. I don't think she can do very hard-locked ones, but still. So I don't have to waste points on science, basically. Yeah. However... Can get this open, at least. Oh, whoa. Here we go. Really?! Ugh. What kind of absolute bastard locks his empty footlocker? I mean, honestly. Did I just see something on there? Straight razor. No, not gonna trim the mustache just yet. Thanks. Please tell me there is a key around here somewhere. Ah, sneaky. Glanton save key. Okay, here we go. Bottle of purified. Ooh, nice. Last night here. Last night here. It's the last night in the cabin, and I just felt like writing for some reason. Maybe it's the thought of Sandra. I can hear a green... Sorry, hear her eyes. What am I on about? I can see her green eyes haunting me as we lie together, still young and bold, alive. Our cabin wasn't too different from this one. Was this all just a lie to make me feel alive again? Has it changed anything? It's quiet up here, except for Tucker's snoring. The lights from Vegas peek through the cracks in the south wall. Some of the boys are bothered by the sound of coyotes, but they put me at ease. They're natural things, doing what they're supposed to do. Maybe it's just my nature to do what I've been doing. I feel it's going to end soon. What would Sandra say if she saw what I'd become? I can't think about it now. We meet Hendershot tomorrow. Gonna need firepower for the next job. Well?
What's up?
Note?
You sure about this?
No, I... Anything to say?
Damn, if it was a snake, it would have bit me. What's the note say?
It mentioned... only one eye, but a blind man could have found that. The safe was fairly easily found, but I took my time with the fucking key, didn't I? So I can't really talk. It mentioned someone named Hendershot. Do you know him?
Never heard of him, but I know someone who might be able to point us in the right direction. Ex-ranger by the name of Vickers. Lives in Freeside. Let's track him down and see if he can get us on track.
So we're gonna go back to Freeside, yeah. Boy. Fine.
Bye.
Right, job's done. What's next? I do believe what's next is let me just check here. I just want to check where exactly this is. Yeah, it's all the way down here, so what we actually want to do next now is can rebuild him. Let's see if Anna knows anything about the lighting shipment order. Yes, lights for the Bison Steve. And this is Anna, is the daughter of Buck Brunson, I believe, the guy who owned the steakhouses or something. And he won lots of poker matches, and that's his place there. This way. Apparently there was, yeah, before Prim went to shit, or something, there was an order placed for some new lights for the place, and we're going to go find out what happened to that particular shipping order. Okay, it's all coming back now. It's all coming back through the haze of, morning after, hangover, after our little do in Vegas. Almost a little bit ashamed to step back in that place after the things we did. Especially the tops. God bless them. We'll have to make it up to them somehow, we really should. You know, like, when we're in a better position financially, maybe we'll go back there and we'll see what we can do, because I feel absolutely terrible. I really do. You know, it's not enough that we just killed Benny, but we insisted on, you know, posing with his corpse and demanding a photo be taken, so... Oof. Dear, oh dear. Okay, dead over here.
Damn robots on the Strip have more firepower than a squad of grunts. You really trust them?
Well, I don't know, that's a bit like saying, do you trust the truck? It's just a machine, isn't it? It's more of a question of, do you trust the guy who's got the remote control for them? Hello, what's this? More ammunition for guns that I don't own. Awesome. Mailbox. Wind's hideout. Should we really just go barging into random shacks belonging to people? Probably not. In fact, we just stole a bunch of... It was probably whoever lives there's ammunition we just nicked. Oh dear. Who are you lot? James Anderson. Hello, James Anderson.
What is it?
What are you doing out here?
Trying to wait out those filthy hobos squatting on my property. Dirty bums don't give a damn about my deed, and the NCR won't send any law to force them out.
Seems to be a common theme. Why did you call it your property? It's an abandoned building.
It was an abandoned building. An NCR inspector found it uninhabited, so they put it up for sale as part of the Homestead Initiative. My farm near Reading was about to go to the Brahmin Barons, so I put everything I had into this lot. Figured I could start a trading post. I bring my entire family and everything we have, only to find this place occupied by hobos. That Ronnie guy is their leader, and he won't budge. I'm getting desperate here, stranger. I might have to take matters into my own hands.
Hobos, they're a disease, and the cure is in my holster. I'll take care of them. That's gem. That's goddamn tempting, isn't it, really? But I can't rightly... Look, I'll try and work something out with them, okay? Even if that something happens to be a .357 caliber bullet.
If you say so. The honcho is a loose cannon, real twitchy. I think they're on dope, mushrooms, something weird. Freaks, all of them. You get rid of them without any killing, and I'll throw in some caps for you. Thanks for doing this, stranger.
Okay, fair enough. The man doesn't want any killing. That's good enough for me. Hey. Otherwise, by the sounds of it, the older... 38 special solution. It's looking kind of tempting. Optional, kill Ronnie and the squatters. I like the caps, actually.
Look, you dumb sodbuster. I won't say it again. Wait. Who the fuck are you?
Oh god. I like when he's going a bit crazy. This is what happens when you type too many damn words in the GEC. I am David Crumpington. Mr. Anderson has the rights to this property. You're going to have to leave. I'm here to eat muffins and kill hobos. I'm all out of muffins. English muffins, as a matter of fact. Mr. Anderson has the rights to this property. You're going to have to leave.
What? We've been on the road for weeks, just trying to survive. We are day to day out here, stranger. We got sick people and a pregnant woman. You want us to uproot and go back out in the wastes? You can wipe my ass with that deed.
Oh, good lord. Ooh, I've never seen an unarmed speech check in a conversation before. That's interesting. What if you and your people signed on to work for Mr. Anderson? Everyone would benefit.
Me? Work for him? I don't know, but I got mouths to feed. We've done every type of odd job out there, so some steady work might be good for us. Fine. You tell Anderson that we'll sign on, so long as he keeps the wages fair and throws in some food for us every now and then.
Seems reasonable.
Prim's a new sheriff. That should keep the powder gangers away.
What on earth the people make of you, Bert, when you walk into a room like that, you know? I mean, there ought to be just an additional dialogue option, you know, in conversations, you know, if you know... Some guy, if you ever return to modding Fallout New Vegas, please do that. Please do that. Please add a brackets, bad motherfucker, close brackets option to certain dialogues in the game. That would just be the best. I don't care if it's not voice acted. You know, I just... Right.
What is it?
Ronnie says they're willing to work for you if you let them stay.
Hobos? You can't be serious. I want them gone, not living next to me. I can't imagine being around those wretches every damn day. The hell of it is that I will need manpower to get this place up and running. I just never imagined I'd be turning to hobos. Okay, stranger, you win. I'll put them on the payroll and give them food and board. They better not slack off, though. I won't tolerate loafing.
There you go. Give me shelter. Quest completed. So yeah, that's a fair deal. Everyone wins. Like I said, you know. Okay, well, moving on then. It was an interesting little detour. Oh, is this it? Here? Right here? I think it is. What did we just get? Oh, don't know. Yeah, this is it. This is it. This is Buck's place. Requires key. Well, it's got this key. Door control terminal. Oh, we've got the of course, yeah. I remember him giving us this password. Okay, disengage lock. Alright, chaps. Yeah, you better come in with me. Yeah, come on in.
Stranger, you better have a good reason for barging in like this. Who are you, and why are you here?
Yeah, Bert's standing over my shoulder, isn't he? And you're wondering why the fuck is there a super mutant barging into my house. I do apologize. I knew I should have left him outside. I'm a friend. Steve sent me to see you. He needs information about this tape.
Steve? Okay, well, that explains how you got my password. But what's this about a tape?
It was with Laurie's plans for rebuilding the Bison Steve.
Let's see that. Yes, that's it. It's got to be.
What is it? Can you tell me where it came from?
Okay, I know it's my uncle's. See these initials etched into it right here? That BB is Buck Brunson. but I don't recognize this NS right here. Wait, it's got to be Nevada Slim. He and my uncle were old poker buddies. They even started the new Mojave Poker series together with Stewie and Pearson. They had a bit of a falling out, I'm afraid. Buck bluffed him off a real big hand one night, thousands of caps at stake. Buck was a little drunk and he showed Slim his cards just for spite. That made Slim real mad.
Oh, I'm no expert, but it just sounded to me like Buck outplayed him fair and square.
Yeah, he did. But Slim don't like to be bluffed like that. Said Buck was making fun of him. Of course Buck wasn't. But it didn't matter to Slim. Slim said their friendship was over, swore he'd get his money back somehow, and stormed out. I don't think they've spoken since. Buck headed out for New Reno a day or so later. It's a shame, because they had been through a lot together, and were old, old friends.
Do you know where this Nevada Slim might be?
He's probably drunk, gambling, or most likely both. He always said he liked Gamora.
Okay, I'm going to see if I can find him then. Thanks very much.
Okay, bye.
Good grief. Okay, well, we're going back to Freeside anyway, I suppose. Oh, there you are. Suppose. I was like, hang on a minute. There should be a big green person stood right there. This is pretty impressive, by the way, just saying. Do you mind if we look around for a bit? Bill Bradley and his orchestra. Let's dance. I love old movie posters. Next bar and restaurant. Hell's Angels. Howard Hughes. That's actually quite appropriate that should be there. Biplanes. Have I ever told you that my great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-grandfather flew biplanes in the First World War? We need to find if they've got a copy of this. Screw Glanton, screw the bounty, screw everything. I want a copy of Hell's Angels, and I want it now.